America is a great country. And America is a country that was founded on the premise of white supremacy and white superiority. I know you have heard in this entire debate, well, there's a difference between heritage and hate, and there's a difference between Southern culture and slavery, and the monuments are celebrating heritage, they're celebrating culture, they're celebrating Southern pride. And people have understood these code words for a long time. So, I grew up in Memphis, Tennessee. And what greets me as a citizen of Tennessee when I go to my state capital in Nashville, where my grandparents lived? Nathan Bedford Forrest. Well, he made a fortune in Memphis as a slave trader. And he was the original Grand Wizard of the KKK. He led a Confederate massacre of black soldiers and white soldiers, American soldiers, during the Civil War. And this monument wasn't put up in 1865 or 1866 with people saying, he's such a hero, we have to recognize him. This monument was built in 1970, 2 years after Martin Luther King was shot in the neck, just down the road from Nashville, Tennessee. And we'll come to that timing as we go through this, because the timing of these monuments, I think, suggests something that's very important in terms of understanding what they're about. When were these monuments built? There were two spikes between the end of the 1800s and about 1921. What else was going on at the exact same time in America? The fact that this was normal, the fact that this was behavior that didn't really shock anybody, tells you something about how deeply white supremacy has been ingrained into American culture. 1921, the black community in Tulsa, Oklahoma was one of the most prosperous communities in America, and the whites there decided they weren't gonna have it. So they simply burned it to the ground. Almost 300 people killed. That's what was going on at the exact same time. There was this explosion of Confederate monuments, an explosion of thanks and praise for people who had done nothing other than fight to maintain white supremacy and slavery. When you think about when these monuments were built and what else was going on in America, it tells you something about the motivation. So how about that second, 1947 to 1968? One thing that people forget about our history is that Reconstruction after the Civil War was actually working. There were over 2,000 black elected officials in America. Businesses that blacks were starting to take hold. And in 1877, I think it was Grover, I can't remember the president, but he got elected and basically said, I'm withdrawing the troops. In 1876, there were 125,000 black registered voters in Louisiana. In 1878, that number dropped to 5,000. And if you're wondering about the flag, it had essentially been dead and buried until 1948, when Strom Thurmond brought it back with the Dixiecrat Party. And once again, they are telling us as clearly as they can what they are about and why they're waving that flag. The party's purpose was clear: we stand for segregation of the races. This is from the editor of the Augusta, Georgia Courier in 1951. Folks, they are saying it as plainly as they can. And yet, we are still having a debate in this country about what this stuff means. I am going through this to try and show you the events that were happening at the same time that this second explosion of monuments in the South to Confederate heroes was being built. And then this happened in 63. Segregation today, segregation tomorrow, segregation forever, and just a few weeks later, the Confederate flag was flying over the University of Alabama. And in September of 1963, these four girls got blown up in this church. This was the young girl that survived. These are the faces of people watching the bodies being taken out of the church. This is what was happening as the second explosion of Confederate monuments was happening in America. So, some of these statues are coming down. They're being removed in the dark of night because the city officials don't want to remove them in the day because there might be disputes, there might be violence, there might be fighting. My only point is this. There is a movement in America that has not been in existence in my lifetime. I was 11 years old in Memphis when King was shot and killed. And I was young, but I was old enough to know enough. And what I'm telling you is the discussions about racial equality that were going on then are nowhere near as deep, as intense, and as revealing as the discussions that are going on today. As scared as I feel and as frustrated as I feel with what's going on in this country, there is a part of me that says we are on the cusp of something. This is a freaking tipping point. And it is going to go one way or the other. Taking down these monuments will not cure the problem, but it is at least an indication that we are ready to deal with the truth.